So we had ourselves an awesome game in the Superdome. The Saints played the 49ers, and it was a game for the ages. It was really fun. And one of the MVPs of that game, without a doubt, was Jimmy Garoppolo. I mean, you can't have a final score like that and not have, one of the MVPs be the quarterback. He ended up throwing the ball 35 times and had 349 yards, so just barely under 10 yards per attempt. And he also had four touchdowns, two just one interception. So tremendous day from Garoppolo, no doubt about it. And that's the way they were able to pick up their 48-46 victory. And what a wild game it was. And he was just doing so many things right. I thought this is maybe his best game he's had in an NFL uniform. It really is. And so let's just jump into what he did that was so effective. And we'll also talk about, the ending and how that all that went down. So first, we'll start things off with this play. This was in the first drive, and he was making some very pinpoint accurate throws from very early on. This one's going to be a cover one hole, so basically that's the coverage, man coverage, but there's also going to be a couple players playing zone. There's also a safety deep off screen, but that's basically what's going to happen. And then for the 49ers, what they're going to do is they're going to run play action to the top half of the screen. And then they're going to have a receiver on the bottom half of the screen run a slant route right there, which is a pretty good route against this type of coverage because it will be open for the first part. And of course, with the linebacker moving in for the play action and also moving up to the top half of the screen for the play action, this can now make that window even wider. So that is where Garoppolo is going to look, and it's where he should look. That's what the play is designed for. And after the ball is snapped, one thing you notice right off the bat is just that Sanders, that's Emmanuel Sanders, that's the guy who's in the circle right there. He's winning his one-on-one matchup easily, so good job there. So you would think that there's going to be a window, especially when you look over and see that the linebacker definitely moved a little bit up to the top half of the screen for the play action. So there definitely is a window. It's not a huge window, but it's actually going to get a lot smaller because if you look at Cam Jordan right there, he is doing a tremendous job of dropping back in the coverage. He was supposed to drop back in the coverage, but he did a tremendous job of selling as though that's not what he was going to do. So therefore, the window that already wasn't going to be huge is now even smaller. Garoppolo has a mailbox he's going to have to fit it through, but that's exactly what he does, and he puts it in a perfect spot where Sanders is then able to not just make the catch, but then make the catch and continue running and pick up even more yards after the catch. Really a tremendous play by Sanders to get open, but really Garoppolo, it's a tremendous throw. And that's what he was really doing all game. It was those pinpoint accuracy type throws. I thought that the first drive was maybe the most impressive drive actually, even though it's just the first drive of the game because the Saints had already gone up seven. That can definitely be a setback. But Garoppolo was able to really just drive, and they were able to get a touchdown of their own, which allowed them to then tie the game up. Like, this play was another play on that very same drive. It's going to be a cover one blitz this time, and that's the route they can look for. It's Deebo Samuel's route. It's a slant route over the middle. Pretty simple, but definitely is a route that can work in this situation. And so also after the ball is snapped, if you look at Deebo, he does a great job of winning his one-on-one matchup. So this is the type of play that you should be able to convert. You should be able to get 7 or 8 yards here, but the real testament of a good quarterback is going to be, does he place it in a spot where the receiver can make the catch and then continue running? And Garoppolo does. Perfect positions that Samuel can make the catch on the run and pick up even more yards. I mean, first off, just a great route by Samuel. He had a great game, but also just a great throw from Garoppolo. Those two paired together, they both made great plays, and that's what resulted in not just a first down, but a big gain. Those are the kind of things you got to look for in a quarterback. It's not just the yardage totals, it's did you maximize your team's yardage totals? And Garoppolo absolutely did. And while I am making this video about Garoppolo, and deservingly so, he played tremendously well, I could just as easily be making this video about seven or eight guys, and one of those guys is Kyle Shanahan. I thought that he had the Saints defense fooled all game. And even in some smaller things, like maybe one of the things I could actually give some credit for is the Saints defense playing poorly. Like, here's sort of what I mean. It's going to be like this play, for example, it's going to be play action to the bottom half of the screen. And then there's something that's going to have Juszczyk run up to the top half of the screen. It's a little play action. They do this from time to time, see if they can get him open. And after the ball is snapped, it is going to work out very well. I mean, as you see, Juszczyk is open. Yes, there's a Saint in the area, but he's rushing to Garoppolo. Juszczyk is going to get wide open. And also, if you look at a Saint linebacker, he's not close enough to the top half of the screen as where he should be. He should have taken a couple of steps higher up once he saw that Juszczyk was running in that direction. He didn't. He got fooled by the play action. So now Juszczyk is easily going to get open. But also, one thing I love to talk about, I've probably talked about this in every San Francisco 49ers video I've made, is Jimmy Garoppolo's footwork. Watch how, so his feet are basically, you know, almost complete opposite of where he would want to be. His left foot is way farther back. Usually you want to be almost rotated, almost 180 degrees. Not quite, but maybe like 150 degrees over. That's where he would want to be. So he is going to very quickly rotate over and then make the throw to Juszczyk, and then they're able to get the first down. That's such a little thing, but it really does matter. It's a lot easier to make those throws and get those throws off quickly if your feet are planted the right way. And Garoppolo definitely doesn't ignore footwork. He definitely, you know, has that mindset of, I gotta get my feet planted, and I think it really pays off. I think it really does, because you don't see him miss those throws too often, and there's a reason for it. Part of that reason is footwork, in my opinion. But also, so I said that the Saints defense made some mistakes, and you're saying, okay, well, that's a mistake, but it happens. Guys get fooled by play action all the time. But let me just take you to the very next play. Well, what are the 49ers gonna do? Basically the same thing. They're going to run play action to the bottom half of the screen, and then it'll be Kittle running up to the top half of the screen. But watch that Saint player right there. You would think that he should have it in his mind of what's going on. But when Kittle runs up there, he just gets completely beat. Kittle's easily able to get into the end zone for a touchdown. Well, I guess not totally easily, but he does get into the end zone for a touchdown, which is all that matters. And that's just something that can't happen. You know, you can't run the same play twice in a row and have it work. And yet it did. So again, Kyle Shanahan doing a good job of saying, hey, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They're falling for this. I'm going to, you know, see what we can do. Admittedly, that was not the only thing that Kyle Shanahan did well, but one of the things he did do well was exploit the New Orleans Saints' weaknesses. That's definitely something he did well. And it's something you have to do well if you're going to win football games. You're going to have to find an opposing team's weakness, especially when you're playing against a really good team like the Saints who don't have many weaknesses. You have to find a weakness, and then you have to exploit it. They did a great job of exploiting it. Really a tremendous performance by the San Francisco 49ers offense against the New Orleans Saints defense. So that was most of it, but there is one more play I do have to break down, and it's the play that won the game for them. I mean, this is the play, and it was honestly more of a George Kittle play than it was a Garoppolo play, but they both definitely had their part, they had their moment, so here's how the play was going to work. The Saints are playing cover two man here, which on a 4th-and-2 is actually a bit of a curious call, because you would usually want to just make sure that you don't give up those 2 yards. That is not really what the Saints are doing. I mean, they kind of are. The man coverage thing does help to a degree, but you think you would usually play cover one and have a linebacker sort of taking away the middle of the field, so that would kind of give Garoppolo only a couple of options. But that's not what they're doing. They're going to play it a little bit safe here, make sure they don't give up anything deep. At least that's the theory, and so it's going to be cover two man, and then for the 49ers, what they're going to do is they're going to have the 3 receivers on the bottom half of the screen run those routes right there. And so the route that might make the most sense would be George Kittle's route, which is going to get just past the first down marker, because A, it's past the first down marker, and you need a first down. You're only down 3. There's 39 seconds left. You can afford to just get 3 yards, get the first down, call a timeout, and then try to work your way downfield. It's something you can do. You have to stay alive. But also, because there's another 49ers receiver running deeper over him, this is now going to clear a little bit of space out, and so Kittle can potentially get open. And as you see right when the ball is snapped, it is working out absolutely perfectly. Kittle is going to get open. This is going to be a first down. So that part already worked out. But watch this throw from Garoppolo. Watch how he puts it in a perfect spot for Kittle, and Kittle does the rest of the work. He even drags another safety and another defensive back about another 15-20 yards further downfield, and gets a face mask call, so turns it into what would have been, you know, even though he made the move to get rid of the first Saints defensive back, because he kind of played it poorly, actually. Even after he made that move, though, he was able to get it from what would have been on the outside of field goal range to way inside field goal range, and eventually a chip shot for the game winner. Really a great play from Kittle. I thought it was just a great game from the 49ers as a whole. I mean, to go into the Saints' home field and get that victory, it's not easy to do. It really isn't easy to get a win in New Orleans, especially the way the Saints have been playing. And it really kind of just goes to show that this is a real team. This is a team to be reckoned with. I think we already kind of knew that, but for them to be able to beat the Saints, who many consider the best team in the NFC, I think the 49ers are trying to prove that they're still, at least, if they're not the best team in the NFC, it's them or the Seahawks. And in my opinion, it is them. I think that they're the most complete team in the NFC. I think, you know, anything can happen, but if I'm having to put money on somebody to win it all, I'm probably in the NFC, I'm probably picking the 49ers. I might pick the 49ers outright. It's tough between them and Baltimore, but you know, the 49ers are definitely one of those teams that is a legitimate team. The only thing that they really have to be worried about is not getting the bye week. I mean, there's such a huge difference between the 2 seed and the 5 seed. It's so tough to win 4 straight games in the playoffs, so especially when 3 of them would be on the road. So they have to get that number 1 seed. They're probably going to have to beat the Seahawks on week 17. That's probably what's going to end up happening, but who knows? It should at least be a fun ride down the stretch, and definitely a very impressive win from the 49ers. They've had quite a few very impressive wins so far this season. So that's just my opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and as always, thanks for watching.